You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
Most writers and radio show hosts know that to connect with your fans, you need to do more than just write books or record the latest podcasts. There are many different elements that go into forming an online platform, but there are also many hidden traps. To make matters worse, solid advice on how to survive the muddy waters is scarce. In the book Hidden Traps, I talk about some of the important issues of working with an online platform, highlighting traps that could put your physical or internet security at risk or be harmful to your reputation. Are your social media posts just links with a few disjointed words making you look like someone who can't complete a sentence? Did your new website cost you more than you anticipated? Are you leaking your personal contact details across the web without even knowing it? Then you need Hidden Traps. Hidden Traps is now available in paperback and ebook from a variety of retailers, including Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and Kobo. Visit blackwolfpublications.com for more details.
Do you need a car? Been shopping only to be turned down because of bad credit, low credit, no credit, bankruptcy, or divorce? Guess what? Today's your lucky day, because now you can buy a car, truck, or SUV, just about any vehicle. It's true. Bad credit? Doesn't matter. No credit? Doesn't matter. Bankruptcy or divorce? It just doesn't matter. As a matter of fact, your job is your ticket to your new vehicle. We're Auto Credit Express, and we've helped thousands of people just like you. Antonio H. told us, great company, got me connected, and the day I went in, I drove off in the car I wanted. 100% worth your time. Need a car? Get started now and drive off as early as today. Just text FINANCE, F-I-N-A-N-C-E, to 357-911 right now to get started. That's FINANCE, F-I-N-A-N-C-E, to 357-911. Auto financing the easy way. Text FINANCE to 357-911.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
Everyone loves liberty. Our rights come from God, not the government. So why are you letting other people tell you what's best for your health care? Exercise your freedom with Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare is a community of people who voluntarily share one another's medical costs. Liberty HealthShare is founded on the idea that most people truly want to help one another. Healthcare sharing allows members to do just that as a true community that supports one another in times of need. Liberty believes people should make decisions for themselves and their families. Members are able to take back the freedom to make their own decisions about their health care. Freedom from guilt or doubt about how your money is used. You have the freedom to direct your health care, not to be dictated to by bureaucrats. Stop letting others tell you what to do and join a community of like-minded people. Exercise your freedom. Join Liberty HealthShare and take back the control of your health care while helping those around you. Call Liberty at 855-58-LIBERTY. Again, that's 855-58-LIBERTY for more information, or you can check them out at libertyhealthshare.org. Again, that's libertyhealthshare.org.
My son was in the Army back during Desert Storm. But even then, he wanted an MBA. He looked at a dozen schools, but only one offered the online education and flexibility he needed while he was in a tent in Iraq, Grantham University. Turns out that Grantham's been delivering affordable, relevant college and advanced degrees for over 65 years. Heck, if they can deliver a quality education to a soldier in a tent overseas, think about the flexibility Grantham can offer you so you can earn your degree too. It doesn't matter how complicated or full your life is, if getting a degree is on your bucket list, you'll want to do what my son did. You'll want to call Grantham. Find out how easy it is to get started on your education so you can check that college degree off your bucket list. Call Grantham right now. 800-910-1370. That's 800-910-1370. Flexible, affordable, relevant. Call 800-910-1370.
At St. Jude, a family never sees a bill at all. It's like the world has been lifted off of your shoulders.
St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, finding cures, saving children. Learn more at stjude.org.
Sometimes writers feel lost, unsure why a passage may not be working. takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing into full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, offering manuscript critiques and line edits through a mentoring editorial style. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your websites. Black Wolf Editorial Services, nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services, visit blackwolfeditorial.com.
You're listening to the Spark Radio Network, internet radio like you've never heard before. Innovation, creativity, and imagination are all said to begin with a spark. So fasten your seatbelt and take the ride of your life and listen for the spark.
You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
My name is Jessie, and I'm proud of the life I have, surrounded by military and aware just how big the world really is. I have a unique perspective on life and the world around us. If you're willing to listen, I'll tell you how I see it, and I won't pull any punches. This is my POV, which stands for Point of View. All right, it's Jesse. How's everybody doing out there tonight? Yes, I miss you when we're not talking. All right, I know I disappeared without telling too many of you, if any of you. But it was unavoidable. So I did what I could. All right. On that note, I've got a whole lot of crazy stuff going on, and we are going to be back in just 1 minute to get this show started properly. And as always, you can follow me on Twitter at Radio Host Jesse, and I will see you on the other side.
Blood, sweat, tears, it's a calling. And if I can't walk, then I'm crawling. It might flicker, but they can't kill the flame.
Everyone loves liberty. Our rights come from God, not the government. So why are you letting other people tell you what's best for your health care? Exercise your freedom with Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare is a community of people who voluntarily share one another's medical costs. Liberty HealthShare is founded on the idea that most people truly want to help one another. Healthcare sharing allows members to do just that as a true community that supports one another in times of need. Liberty believes people should make decisions for themselves and their families. Members are able to take back the freedom to make their own decisions about their healthcare. Freedom from guilt or doubt about how your money is used. You have the freedom to direct your healthcare, not to be dictated to by bureaucrats. Stop letting others tell you what to do and join a community of like-minded people. Exercise your freedom. Join Liberty HealthShare and take back the control of your healthcare while helping those around you. Call Liberty at 855-58-LIBERTY. Again, that's 855-58-LIBERTY for more information. Or you can check them out at libertyhealthshare.org. Again, that's libertyhealthshare.org.
Swinging for the fences. It's like this heart is defenseless against a passion that's pumping through my veins. Blood, sweat, tears, it's a calling. And if I can't walk, then I'm crawling. It might flicker, but they can't kill the flame.
All right, thank you for hanging in there with me while we paid those radio station bills. Yes, I am back. I am live. Now, tomorrow night, we are going to have a very special show. I have a guest tomorrow, someone I have been trying to get on for some time. And that would happen to be Matt Ward. And I know you're all sitting there going, who is Matt Ward? Well, Matt happens to be a military YouTuber who discusses all kinds of things about joining the military, officer versus enlisted. He was prior enlisted until he was commissioned earlier this year. And he's got a very fascinating and reasonably informed take on the military. So you want to definitely tune in for that tomorrow. All right, now what do I have on tap for you tonight? Tonight. Okay. Well, do we start with Russia? Why not? Russia, Russia, Russia. Although I'm not talking collusion. Somebody else can talk that one. I've got other fish to fry with Russia. When a Chinese warship sailed 135 feet from the bow of the USS Navy destroyer Decatur on Sunday, a distance so close, the American ship commander had to make last-second maneuvers to avoid a collision. It was the latest in a series of close calls. Wasn't the first, probably won't be the last. During Sunday's close encounter, the Chinese warship initially shadowed the Decatur, an event, and got closer than it should have. How often do these unsafe interactions occur? Not often. But when they do, they are attention getters. If the incidents are deemed dangerous enough, the U.S. will file a formal complaint with China or Russia. But in the end, all that usually happens is the U.S. military issues statements reaffirming its right to sail or fly through international waters and airspace. The encounters with Russia and China have been occurring in alarmingly increasing frequency. But there are different reasons for it. U.S. officials believe Russia's encounters are prompted by Russia's effort to reassert itself militarily around its borders. China's are a reflection of that nation's use of its military to bring back up its aggressive territorial claims on the South China Sea. There have been Russian military aircraft buzzing American ships, flying too close to American planes. All kinds of things. In January, the United States claims a Russian Su-27 fighter jet came within 5 feet of a Navy EP-3 surveillance plane flying in international airspace above the Black Sea. Yeah, that's super close. The Navy labeled the encounter unsafe because unprovoked, the Russian fighter crossed directly through the EP-3's flight path. Can't talk tonight. Causing the surveillance aircraft to fly through the Russian plane's jet wash. Now, jet wash can really rock a plane. The USS Donald Cook was buzzed more than 30 times by Su-27 fighters. On one occasion, they flew as close as 30 feet from the ship. The Pentagon later released video and images to demonstrate how risky the Russian maneuvers were. Typically, the Navy carries out freedom of navigation exercises, and usually they are in the South China Sea. but... This wasn't the first, it won't be the last. While ships often maintain a safe distance, there have been two previous encounters with where the Chinese Navy almost caused a collision. On December 2013, a U.S. Navy cruiser, the USS Cowpens, narrowly avoided a collision with a Chinese PLA Navy warship that the U.S. said had been harassing it. Again in 2009. Do you see the pattern? By the way, American planes flying in international airspace through the China Sea also face constant Chinese radio messages demanding that they leave what they say is China's airspace. So it's definitely both China and Russia doing it. It's hard to say which one is the bigger pain in the neck, but neither one is good for our armed forces. Now, Russia, I'm not done yet. Russia completed the delivery of the S-300 air defense systems to Syria. Sergei Shoigu said in televised remarks that Russia has delivered four S-300 launchers along with radars and support vehicles. Shoigu said it will take 3 months to train Syrian personnel to operate the system. Russia announced the S-300 delivery to Syria after the September 17th downing of a Russian reconnaissance plane by Syrian forces responding to an Israeli airstrike. It was definitely a friendly fire incident that stoked all kinds of regional tensions. Russia is the key ally of Syrian President Bashar al-Assad. And if it wasn't for Russia and Iran propping up Assad, that country would be in worse shape than it is now. And speaking of Syria, I've got a very lengthy, but I am going to break it up, audio clip here from Secretary of Defense Mattis from today's press conference in France.
Well, to answer your question about what do we do post-ISIS, first of all, ladies and gentlemen, we are still in a tough fight. Make no mistake about it, as ISIS has collapsed inward in their own way, they have reinforced the center as they've been forced into what is now less than 2% of their original territory that they held. So it's going to still be a tough fight. I don't want anyone to be under any illusions, and we're together in that fight, and we will be successful, but it's still going to take some time.
Now that is the key point he wanted to make. It's a tough fight. It's going to take time. But he does continue. Let's keep listening.
But the question is valid. So then what? First of all, as you see in territory uncovered against ISIS to date, we help to set up local councils of people who live in the area, and then we create security forces, local security forces, who are stronger than what we ordinarily call police. The reason is to restrict ISIS from rising once again, you're going to have very well-armed, well-trained local security forces who reflect the local ethnic composition so they have support from people in the communities. This takes time to train them, equip them, and at this point in time, still to reinforce them.
Now, the biggest thing he said here was local trained security forces. Let's back that up a bit.
Restrict ISIS from rising once again, you're going to have very well-armed, well-trained local security forces who reflect the local ethnic composition so they have...
It's definitely one of those things that the security forces have to reflect the local composition. And it's definitely one of those things, without it reflecting the local composition, they're not going to succeed. They're going to fail. It's always better if your local security forces, police, what have you, are made up of a similar ethnic composition as to the neighborhoods, areas, regions, and cities they're patrolling. Now let's pick back up with Secretary of Defense Mattis.
Support from people in the communities. This takes time to train them, equip them, and at this point in time, still to reinforce them until we actually shatter ISIS as a fighting force. In the months following the final defeat, we will continue this creating security that prevents ISIS from returning. But every step of the way, the coalition is united behind the UN Special Envoy, and this is Stephen de Mistura, and the Geneva process. This is the true solution to the tragedy that we now think of when we call out the name Syria.
All right, he made another great point here. Let's back it up and take another listen, and I'll explain why these points are so important.
Insecurity that prevents ISIS from returning. But every step of the way, the coalition is united behind the UN Special Envoy, and this is Stephen de Mistura, and the Geneva process.
All right, the Geneva process is the one backed by the United Nations. It is the one that, in my mind, has the best chance of actually succeeding. Is it going to? Only time will tell.
This is the true solution to the tragedy that we now think of when we call out the name Syria. It is, how do we restore peace to Syria and do so through the Geneva process? And we will have to do this, obviously, despite Russia's efforts to marginalize the United Nations in this effort. So we're under no illusion.
Yes, Russia has been trying to cut the United Nations and the United States out of these agreements at every turn. Probably because we are such a huge United Nations supporter. So let's back this up once again.
And do so through the Geneva process. And we will have to do this, obviously, despite Russia's efforts to marginalize the United Nations in this effort. So we're under no illusions about the challenge, but we do have a plan for how we go forward. Our diplomats there on the ground have been doubled in number. As you see the military operations becoming less, you will see the diplomatic effort now able to take root.
That's important. The diplomats on the ground in the region have doubled. And while they may not continue to double, you can definitely expect Secretary of Defense Mattis to call out a spade for a spade every time he sees it. In fact, he was calling Russia out today.
On the INF Treaty, I think many of you are aware that for 4 years, two American administrations have had diplomatic discussions with Russia. This is a treaty that is only signed between Russia and the United States, but it has very, very strong links to the security of Europe and the security of NATO. So what are we willing to do after 4 years of diplomatic efforts to try to bring Russia back into compliance?
Russia has not been in compliance with the INF Treaty for many years. He doesn't want to have to start from ground zero and renegotiate a new treaty because Russia right now is speaking with forked tongue. Let's continue listening.
On the INF treaty, I think many of you are aware that for 4 years, two American administrations have had diplomatic discussions with Russia. This is a treaty that is only signed between Russia and the United States, but it has very, very strong links to the security of Europe and the security of NATO. So what are we willing to do after 4 years of diplomatic efforts to try to bring Russia back into compliance? One of the reasons I'm here this week, or one of the subjects I will bring up this week, and I've already previewed with our trusted ally, France, is I want the advice from the NATO nations. What do we do with a treaty that two nations entered into, one is still living by, that's us, the United States, and Russia is not.
He doesn't want to just go this alone. We could, because Russia's breaking a treaty they signed with us. And the Intermediate Nuclear Forces Treaty was signed, for the record, in 1987. And U.S. Ambassador to NATO, Kay Bailey Hutchinson, said she thought that the U.S. and Russia could find a diplomatic solution to the treaty violation, but they would use force if necessary. She isn't talking about a preemptive strike. She's talking about U.S. countermeasures against Russian nuclear weapons and not a preemptive strike. I want to make that clear. The U.S. has responded with a variety of its own comparable nuclear forces deployed to Europe in the Cold War. And this is how this treaty got started. Because in Europe, during the Cold War, Moscow in the 1980s placed nuclear missiles capable of striking European capitals from its own turf. And they had them all targeted. Striking Russian missile facilities in Russia could trigger a war. That is not what we want. We have been trying to send the message to Russia for years. We know you're breaking this treaty. We have evidence you are breaking this treaty. And now we are laying down markers so our allies will help us bring Russia to the table. Because, believe it or not, this treaty is very important. Because Russia could simply say, well, we're putting our missiles back, so we're set up to strike all the European capitals. Now, Washington has shared intelligence evidence with 28 NATO allies that Russia is developing ground-fired cruise missile, and the system could give Moscow the ability to launch a nuclear strike in war Europe with little or no notice. Now, Russia's claimed U.S. missile defenses violate the pact. However, our missile defense systems are defensive. They are not designed for offensive use. There will come a point in the future, and this is according to Hutchinson, I just don't have the audio, that America will determine it has to move forward with the development phase that's not allowed by the treaty right now. Especially if Russia keeps violating it. Washington wants its NATO allies to ramp up the diplomatic pressure on Moscow. And Hans Stoltenberg, the NATO Secretary General, is very concerned by Russia's continued work. And Stoltenberg has said that the INF treaty is a crucial element of transatlantic security, which is now in danger because of Russia's actions. Again, I don't have the audio, or I'd use it. Yeah, think that's all Russia's up to? Nope, but since this one ties into North Korea, we are going to take a brief commercial break. And as always, I will see you on the other side. Remember, you can always follow me on Twitter at Radio Host Jesse. And you can email me at the station at jessepov@klrnradio.com.
Can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. No, I'll stand my ground, won't be turned around. And I'll keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground.
Most writers and radio show hosts know that to connect with your fans, you need to do more than just write books or record the latest podcasts. There are many different elements that go into forming an online platform, but there are also many hidden traps. To make matters worse, solid advice on how to survive the muddy waters is scarce. In the book Hidden Traps, I talk about some of the important issues of working with an online platform, highlighting traps that could put your physical or internet security at risk or be harmful to your reputation. Are your social media posts just links with a few disjointed words making you look like someone who can't complete a sentence? Did your new website cost you more than you anticipated? Are you leaking your personal contact details across the web without even knowing it? Then you need Hidden Traps. Hidden Traps is now available in paperback and ebook from a variety of retailers, including Amazon, Barnes & Noble, and Kobo. Visit blackwolfpublications.com for more details.
If you're 85 or younger, would you like peace of mind and comfort for your family? We're Final Expense Direct with an urgent message for you. The average funeral today costs over $8,000, but the most you'll get from government benefits is $255. How will your family pay the difference? We can help. Our senior plans start as low as just a dollar a day and pay up to $30,000 for a funeral and other final expenses. Peace of mind is easy. There's no medical exam. You'll have lifetime coverage, and your plan can't be canceled as long as you pay your premiums. Call now for free information about our senior plans. Answer a few simple questions and receive approval right on the phone. Plus, call right now, and we'll give you a discount prescription card for free. Call 800-553-8687. That's 800-553-8687. Again, 800-553-8687.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
Radio station bills. I was not intending to talk North Korea tonight, but they wouldn't stay quiet. So, here we go. This one's rich. This one's just absolutely rich. Have to read this one.